Hey, true believers and fellow theme park fans, we are going to dine at the Paradiso 37. Now, gotta tell you, I've heard rumors that we may be in for a not-so-treatable treat here. But you know what? Everything deserves its day in court, so let's give it a shot.
Man. All right, so we requested this view out here for Paradiso 37. We figure it's nice and cool, so why don't we chill out outside? It's me and the professor here. So far, so good, except they gave us this, we sat at this table, and it is a very, very wobbly thing. All righty.
Food is stable.
Yeah. The weird thing is they gave us one menu. So I guess it's going to be the professor's turn, and then I get a turn to figure out what I want to eat.
Hey, Santa Claus is out there, kids. That is really cute. You know, I do not like, nor do I agree with all of this COVID stuff, but at least they're trying. In some ways they are trying. I just wish they would tell their employees to be a little bit more polite when talking about masks and all that kind of stuff. It should still be about the magic and not the masks. But dang, I think that's kind of cool.
So we were given the pitch, and the P37, it stands for the 37 countries in the South America and the South and North America. So there you go. And that's what the dining looks like. That's what the food looks like. It looks like it's a bit of Caribbean. You got different flavored burgers. I went for the Nashville hot. Professor went for the Honolulu pulled pork sandwich. But to me, it really appears like you can make a meal out of the appetizers and be happy. If it's good, and that's still up in the air. But we had to move, and this is my new view anyway. I was kind of rude and took the seat beforehand, and we see Santa Claus still over there doing his thing. Unfortunately, I gotta say, the professor's view is not as dynamic.
I get a dock. A little concrete dock, but enough.
Alrighty, now for the appetizer, me and the professor decided to go with a South American crazy corn. It's fire roasted corn on the cob, and it says Aji Amarillo and P37 cheese. So there you go. It looks good. Alrighty, we're gonna bite into this and then give it its day in court here. Alright, the entrees came almost right out at the same time as the appetizer. I got that Nashville chicken sandwich. Okay, and then we've got the pulled pork from the professor. I'm telling you, by looks, I think the professor won this one, but we'll check how the flavor is. Alrighty, so we've had our lunch. Professor, give us your take on Paradiso 37 and the sandwiches, the appetizer, the whole nine yards.
Well, whenever they brought out the appetizer, that was delicious. That cheese melted all over the corn. That was great. When they brought out the food a few minutes after, it was like, I'm still in the middle of it.
Yeah.
But that's no big deal. And whenever we got the sandwiches, because I got to try both, that Honolulu barbecue one, that was delicious. The sweetness of it all, just... I would come back for that.
Yep.
And as for the Nashville hot, it was an enjoyable Nashville hot chicken sandwich. None of the food here was bad, so I've never heard anything about this place. So I was pleasantly surprised with how decent it was.
And do you think it was worth the price?
At least I would say it's worth the price. I believe it was $18
For your burger, it was, or the pork sandwich, it was $18. And yeah, for the corn, it was
$16. The corn might be just a little bit overpriced with how much they give, because those corn pieces, even though they were good, they were kind of small.
They were small.
Yeah. But it, overall, it's a fair price.
Alrighty.
My main sandwich, the one that I picked, was the Nashville hot chicken sandwich. Now, I did something myself. I kind of talked myself into believing this is going to be a Nashville hot sandwich. It is a Nashville hot chicken sandwich, so it came with bacon, it came with lettuce and tomato on it. When a Nashville sandwich comes with pickles and a little bit of mayonnaise and is incredibly hot. The burger, or the chicken itself, was actually spicy. Not so spicy that if you're used to spicy food, you would feel it, but I believe Professor, he was like, "Oh, I feel the burn." But I am very much used to this kind of thing, so I was like, it's okay. But here's the thing, the flavors were there. And if you want a not-so-spicy sandwich, this will do it for you. But do not make a mistake. This is a spicy chicken sandwich rather than Nashville hot. Nashville hot makes you cry to your mama. That's the way it should be. But the aioli they had on it was flavorful, and it worked well. The tomato was fresh, the lettuce was fresh, and it served as a kind of a sweet aside to the spiciness of the chicken. Thank you. Alrighty. And then we have the pulled pork sandwich, which I thought the pork was fighting with the pineapple for the star of the show. This is it's more of a pineapple sandwich with pulled pork on it.
I get that.
Yeah, it's a very sweet sandwich. It was flavorful, it was good. And here's the thing, the professor and I halved each sandwich so we could talk about them. I think that if you were to eat one of either, then it would be more spicy because it would have had a build to it, or you would have gotten more pork versus pineapple or something along that line. So I would definitely say it's a flavorful sandwich, and for $18 at a Disney park, not bad for the pulled pork, but for $21, even at a Disney park, they need to bring that down by about, I don't know, $4 or $5, in my opinion, to make it worth it. We did get that sweet corn, it's called the South American Crazy Corn. I love corn. I make it at my house. I love doing all the sorts of flavoring to it and everything. The flavors are there. It is good. I liked it. I would have liked, I think, a little bit more pepper underneath the cheese, or some salt and pepper, you know, give paprika even. Give some sort of flavor underneath the cheese. Otherwise, I did think it was flavorful, but this is a $10. That's a $10 appetizer. And that's a big problem with this place. I think the flavors are decent. And I only heard bad things about this place, so I'm actually surprised that I like it as much as I did. It's just, I think it's a little too expensive for what it offers.
That's fair, but I always expect, whenever we go to Disney, that
you're
going to
pay a little extra. Yeah. I get that. And here's the thing. I don't think it's like miles expensive for what it has to offer.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. It's like it's got delusions of grandeur. But there you go. And that's my take on Paradiso 37. When I come back, I've already planned to come back. While we were talking about it, I said, if me and Gail are coming here, I would get the nachos, or I would get the nachos and the poutine look like they would make for a meal by itself. Just order those two and two people could go crazy. So that's my take on it. And yeah, I would definitely come back as well.
And then there was a dog named Peanut. I don't get the
I think
Disney.
These are reindeer.
They're reindeer?
Yeah.
Okay, reindeer named Peanut.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, things that I can get fatter from. What is this?
Literally everything.
Oh, that looks so good. I don't see what the title is, though. Just says decorated. Oh, my goodness.
That's just a Rice Krispie treat. Oh,
yeah.
Go
on ahead. Go on ahead. We're still looking. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the castle there was so much to do, but it wasn't a hassle. Minnie and the elves were busy wrapping up every toy while Donald baked cookies, cupcakes, what looks like a log roll and other cookies. Sweet holiday treats for all to enjoy.
Pluto lined up the reindeer, Chip and Dale checked off the list, Daisy and Goofy packed up the sleigh, making sure that nothing was missed. Now Mickey was all set, dressed in a something that said behind there, you can't even tell the ending there. Alrighty gang, that's merchandising for you. Alrighty gang, we are here at Aristo Crepe, and we got the Santa Crepe. That is kind of cool looking.
I am hoping it's good.
It's definitely hot because the whipped cream's melting on it.
I said it was very close.
And it is $6.99, filled with eggnog, custard, praline pieces, topped with whipped cream, chocolate sauce, sprinkle, served cold, which is weird because, yeah, that's melting. Yeah. Go figure. Alrighty, I also got this Cherry's Jubilee Bubble Waffle filled with vanilla ice cream, topped with whipped cream, cherry Jubilee sauce, and praline pieces. And she is making this right over here. Alright, whoa, that is filled with whipped cream. This is right across the street from the Rainforest Cafe, which I, at this point, do not recommend. And this is a big old boat of food right here. This diabetes waiting to happen, but my goodness, it looks like delicious, delicious diabetes. Now, I don't know if you can see it because it is dark, but there is half of that Cherry's Jubilee left. It is huge.
Mm-hmm.
And as Professor Pixel says, I'm tapping out, man. I cannot finish this. But it was good, it was flavorful. I liked the waffle underneath. It was actually the edges is nice and a little bit toasted. I don't want to say burnt, but it was toasted just enough to give it a little crunch. It was filled with so much whipped cream though, and I think they need to cut back a little bit. The star should not be the whipped cream. The star should be the Cherry's Jubilee, which is delicious. There's enough sweetness to the praline to counteract the sourness of the cherry. You definitely need that ice cream as well. Really good. It's $8.99 and it's definitely worth it because this easily feeds two people. This is a dessert for two people.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, you got a really fat guy and a tall, skinny kid, and we couldn't finish it ourselves. But then again, he did wipe out his crepe, so
yeah,
there you go.
The Santa crepe was good. The eggnog flavor wasn't so overpowering that it ruined the crepe. I'm not a big fan of eggnog, so if you're an eggnog fan, you'll still probably like it. It has enough flavor in there. It's definitely good.
Well,
and
I thought with the chocolate syrup, the whipped cream, the crepe itself, it actually cuts a little bit into the eggnog because the eggnog is not a strong eggnog flavor.
No, it's lighter than if you were drinking a cup of eggnog. The Cherry's Jubilee, I agree with everything you said. It was very flavorful. I actually like that more than this, but they're both worth the price they're listed.
Yeah, because that was $5.99, and this is $8.99, the Cherry's Jubilee. It's at Aristocrepe's. Come and give it a try.
Yeah.